I didn't think it was gonna be that exciting. I didn't think it was gonna be like, whoa.
Nisha, what a Inglorama.
I can't do this. Nadim, 你好，欢迎来到京剧联系上。请在7点半到达人民剧场，并寻找一位美丽的女子。Okay, all right.
My name is Nadim, and as a show host in China, I've shadowed people from different walks of life to know more about their work. Rural doctors, forest rangers, and poverty alleviation officials. Now, I want to challenge myself and learn a new trade, for real this time. So I've decided to become a jingju apprentice. But there's a catch. I only have 100 days to learn an art that takes years to master. This is my journey to the jingju stage.
How do I feel about studying jingju? Oh my god, it's a mixed bag of emotions right now. So there's the good things, you know, the excitement, the happiness of doing something that I'm genuinely interested in. But at the same time, you have a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of hesitation, a little bit of fear, in healthy doses, of course. Ni hao.
我要找一位美丽的女孩，是你吗？请问你是李龙吗？对，是我。啊，那你说的那位美丽的女子就是我了。<笑>你好。你好。首先欢迎你到国家京剧院京剧艺术展陈馆做客。
是是。
好，接下来我很荣幸的为李龙去讲解我们国家京剧院京剧艺术展陈馆的三层实物性的道具展示，领略中国戏曲文化的京剧魅力。
I thought I knew what I needed to know about jingju before going in, but after meeting her, I realized that everything is deliberate in jingju. There's nothing that is left to chance.
妈妈，我想要考考李龙。您知道这个道具是叫什么名字吗？这个，
不知道。这个呢，就是我们舞台上所用的马鞭。这个我知道，但是的名字我不知道。那么，一根马鞭就代表着策马飞腾，一根船桨呢，就代表着乘风破浪。
粉色的马鞭，京剧戏曲演员在舞台上穿的这个戏衣，粉色的戏衣和他的身份地位。 还有服饰的颜色都是相承相形的，是这样的一个寓意。
Meng Yuan is such a knowledgeable person. She is a walking encyclopedia related to jingju. Whatever I know is literally a drop in a bucket of her knowledge. She even put that little cap on my head, and I thought that you would learn faster if you get to, you know, touch the things and to play with them. I mean, I say play, but it's like out of, it's done with respect, of course.
接下来就恭喜你正式的进入到京剧练习生的环节，开始你的京剧之旅吧。Okay.
恭喜你 Nadim， 你已经开启了京剧练学生的挑战之旅。接下来您要去梅兰芳大剧院找你的领路人，星期教室如下。
是要找一个国字脸型，方方正正、很端正的脸型的老师。Okay,
whatever that means.
好的，加油！谢谢你，谢谢你，我来喽。These
three clues are not exactly helpful. So a male performer, it could be anyone. Especially that I'm going to a jingju theater. 你好，不好意思，我要问你，你是京剧演员吗？对，你是我的领路人吗？啊，领路人，领路人，领路人，对，我不是，你不是，好，OK，不好意思，没关系，谢谢你，谢谢你，OK， that's not him. 你们好，啊，你好，我要问你，你是京剧演员吗？我不是，京剧演员不是，啊，但是都是女孩，我找一个男孩。 I can't do this. I cannot interrupt them.
Wow, it was extremely nerve-wracking. It was a scary experience. I didn't want to be just added pressure because I would think that they're under a lot of pressure to perform, you know, perfectly.
Hello, 我现在要找我的领路人，他是一个京剧演员，还有郭子莲，你知道他会是谁吗？是，应该还是那个吧。我等他下来，你问问他吧。他？啊，对，你问问他。你好。
打扰一下，我要问你，你是我的领路人吗？猜对了，小王。你好，你好，你好，京剧欢迎你。啊，谢谢，
谢谢，谢谢。你有可能比较忙，所以我们可以一会儿。
可以，我们随时都可以。啊，我们这儿也训练的差不多了。啊，OK，就排练的差不多了。啊，好。那我就带你可以在我们的剧场。
台前幕后，我们可以走一走，看一看。可以，好吧。可以，好，谢谢。第一眼看到他以后，我觉得他是个很可爱的外国小伙子，啊，也很腼腆啊。他要挑战100天，要学一个京剧的一个片段，我觉得本身有难度，啊。昨天正好是我们演出，他到了后台，那么我跟他一起，啊，到了我们的化妆间。
到了我们的舞美的各个部门进行了一个简单的向他的一个介绍。现在呢，我们来到了后台，我们的帽子摆在这里。
对，
啊，这是今天晚上我们要用所有的。然后这些胡子，我们叫做染口。啊，对，每个行当都有戴胡子的机会。那么今天你看到我戴了一个黑白相间的。
嗯，对。
你猜猜我是青年人？ 还是中年人，还是老年人？老年人有白色，黑色代表青年人。那么你看看，黑色和白色之间的这个
，OK，
啊，又应该是中年人了。好，对，我们在交谈的过程当中，我能感觉到他很绅士，他始终是先听你说完以后，他再回答。那么我就感觉他的个性呢比较沉稳，也比较内向。
那么我觉得这样的性格更加适合去思考，这点我非常喜欢。我们再往里走。好，我的剧装就是这个。哦，对，这个旗子就是靠旗的一部分。我们会看到上面啊有这样的像鳞片一样的感觉。这个其实就是代表盔甲。那么这个靠旗扎在身上以后，一是显着特别的气势特别大，我们说八面雷锋。那么还有呢，这个在真正战争当中，其实它是保护我们 头颅的这样的一个作用，对。但是到了戏曲当中呢，我们把它夸张夸大了。那么等一会儿到了七点钟左右，我们准备要上场的时候，我们就可以看到穿上是一个什么样的状态。那么，哎，这里会有剧照，我们可以看到。看，这些就是盔甲，装备上以后的样子啊，上面是靠旗，底下是靠身，那么也就是盔甲的样子了。
OK。
Either in the morning with Meng Yuan, in the afternoon with Liu Dake, or any of the people that I bothered in the backstage, everyone was just so welcoming and helpful. And I think that gives me a lot of hope that I might be on the right track That's what's gonna make me sleep at night tonight.
京剧的这种传承也好，或者说他的训练演员和西方是非常不同。嗯，西方首先我们说，要是演一出戏，它有剧本，
啊对。
如果要是演一部歌剧，它有唱本。
对。
但是京剧不是，京剧是师傅教徒弟，所以我们小时候学戏都是没有任何记录的，就是老师怎么跟你说，完全靠心里，我们把它默默地记下来。
From the outside, I was like, okay, yeah, I hear you. But inside of me, there was this turmoil because my heart was racing. And I'm like, okay, how am I supposed to do this? At one point, I have to learn a script, and there's no script. I didn't think it was gonna be that exciting. I didn't think it was gonna be like, whoa. I saw one of the characters, even though he had the shui xiu, but there was just one pinky out. And even that, he was moving it in a very peculiar way. I was able to see how the beard was moving with every word that comes out of his mouth, because I think he was using such a forceful voice. And so it's all these details that you wouldn't be able to see online, and you can only see them in sitting among the audience and the live performance. And I thought that was fascinating, because not in a million years, no matter how much you watch online, clips and jingju, jiemu, you would never be able to see that. It's a whole new experience, either being an audience watching the jingju play today, or the behind the scenes, because I've never been in both situations before. No matter how many videos you watch, or no matter how many plays you watch online, or DVDs or movies, it's just a different feeling. You're immersing yourself in this art form, and it's just a completely, completely different feeling. Day one is finally over. It was tiring, but very magical. Before today, I had never seen a jingju outfit in person, let alone be within this much distance from something not only of artistic, but also historical significance. In more good news for me, I got to meet my guide, Liu Dake, and he seems like a pretty nice guy, quite cheerful. I also got to see him live in action, which was pretty cool. The cherry on top of a fantastic day. I am extremely excited to be on this journey and cannot wait to see what the next 99 days hold for me.